I will start with the one for Uganda. Because as is my custom, every new year I declare prophecies according to what God would have shown me. This year, look at your neighbor and say, this year,
this year
is not a different year.
Not a different year.
I know it sounds awkward for us to say this year when in terms of Gregorian reasoning, we are still in the year 2022. But in terms of our understanding, the understanding which God is giving us today, we know we are in the year 5,783. Hallelujah. It's a happy new year. Look at your neighbor and say, it's a happy new year. Say, it's a happy new year. Yes, in this happy new year, my first specific prophetic message is for Uganda. It is entitled The Next King of Uganda. The Next King of Uganda. Hallelujah. Someone will say, but you are not gender sensitive. Why didn't you say the next queen? If I've seen a woman, I could have said the next queen of Uganda. But because I've seen a man succeed, a man, that's why I'm talking about the king of Uganda. The next king of Uganda. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So straight away, it must tell you that the one who is coming after the current king is also a man like him. Say, he is also a man like him. Yes, I've spoken about this man at an earlier time in parables. Today, I'm going to just describe him. So the message looks like it's in parables, but for those who know, they'll clearly see who I'm referring to. Hallelujah. Say, the next king of Uganda. I know it will anger a lot of people who believe in the court of democracy or the quarters of democracy. I don't know whether the court of democracy is male or female or transgender. Maybe the court of democracy is transgender. Who knows? Those who believe in democracy, they will say, Uganda is a democracy. Why are you talking of a king? I told you that the current man who is sitting on the seat of power, every time I see him in a vision, he will be wearing a crown. That's why the way he behaves, he can't help it. He's a king in spite of himself. Look at your neighbor and say, he is a king in spite of himself.
He is a king in spite of himself.
Yes, somehow in his heart of hearts, he tries to be a Democrat, but is a king in spite of himself. He tries by all means. He looks for the curtains of democracy, the frills of democracy, the clothing of democracy, to wear like a Democrat, but he is a king in spite of himself. There are some leaders of nations that I don't see with crowns. But those that I see with crowns, it means they are actually kings. It means they actually want kings. I will digress a bit from this prophecy. Like this nation where I am standing, this nation where I am standing is actually a kingdom. In this nation where I am standing, elections do not work, and they will not work because it's a kingdom. In case you wanted me to tell you who will be president, whether the current kingdom will go out of power in 2020, I might as well, match the prophecies since it's a happy new year. In all countries where I've seen their leaders wearing crowns, like even in this country, I've seen the leader who is reigning after the former leader who ran for quite a bit of time wearing a crown. This current leader is also wearing a crown, but he will run a shorter period of time, as I've said in the past. Hallelujah. Zimbabwe, just let me help you so that you will be serious with prayer for this nation. If there are certain changes that you desire, which you are banking on the God or goddess of democracy bringing about. As an intercessor, isn't it I'm talking to intercessor? Let me help you in case you don't see things which are naked before your eyes. Zimbabwe is a kingdom. Kingdom. K-I-N-G-D-O-M. May I have my pot so that I can prophesy with the pot? The things that I'm doing today, I'm just playing. Because people have been asking, what will happen next year, Pastor Ian Ndlovu? Next year, what will happen? What will happen next year is that we will still be in the kingdom. I've helped you. That's where I begin to irritate a lot of people. But at least I try to speak the truth that I would have seen in the prayer closet. I said, I know there are so many things that you know about Zimbabwe. But one of the things that you need to know about this country to function properly and to remain sane in this country, to remain sane and not develop mental health problems in this country, is to know what I'm telling you. That Zimbabwe, this thing called Zimbabwe, Chinuchavo. Zimbabwe is a kingdom. And I'm not even prophesying about Zimbabwe. I'm talking about Uganda. I'm just using Zimbabwe as an illustration to assist us to understand where we are. The reason why Daniel prospered in Babylon is because he understood the kingdom that he was in. For you to prosper in a particular place and at a particular time, you must understand where you are. And like the sons of Issachar, you must understand the times in which you are. If you don't understand where you are and you start to imagine yourself in New Zealand, when you are in the kingdom of Zimbabwe, you will develop a lot of stress, unnecessary stress as a Christian. Most of the stress that I see many Christians, including pastors, having, it's unnecessary stress, which is caused by their failure to recognize the naked fact that this country, Zimbabwe, is a what?
Kingdom.
You can move the pot a bit. So, I'm talking about Uganda. And I'm just about to read the message that I recorded in the prayer closet about the next king of Uganda. I've seen him in an earlier vision, hunting with his father. So I was not certain whether whatever they were discussing with his father, whether the thing had been accepted by God, sanctioned by God to be, or it was them trying to shape history according to their own ways. Until God said, in this period of Rosh Hashanah, I must come and tell the intercessors, so that the intercessors in that country, they won't stress themselves and most probably lose life and limb to try to change what they cannot change. There is time for everything. Look at your neighbor and say, there is time for everything.
There is time for everything.
Say, there is time for everything.
There is time for everything.
This current kingdom, because I'm speaking the message about Uganda, but I'm also talking about the kingdom of Zimbabwe. This current kingdom has got its expiry date. This current kingdom, it has got its expiry date. Hallelujah. I will talk about this kingdom during the course of this year, which we have just entered. Hallelujah. I will talk about this kingdom. This kingdom, I'm referring to the kingdom of Zimbabwe. But today, I'm not going to dwell on the kingdom of Zimbabwe. We want to examine the kingdom of Uganda. The kingdom of what? Of Uganda. Look at your neighbor and say, the kingdom of Uganda. I know most, there are some people, especially in Uganda, who are going to be angry at my message. And they will, some have got a habit of insulting me on the internet. I'm now used to that. It goes with the territory. If you are a prophetic intercessor and God shows you something, expect to be persecuted for the things that God shows you. They did that to people in the Bible. Definitely they would do it to people outside the Bible who believe in the Bible. Hallelujah. Say, the kingdom of Uganda. Yes. So I've seen the next king in earlier visions. And one of the most recent visions that I saw the earlier king, I mean the next king who is coming after the current king, it's a vision of him hunting with his father in the bush. So God willing, I may state that vision and most probably give the interpretation. It's up to the Spirit of God. So I will read the message. It is as follows. I have seen this man in an earlier vision, but over the past 2 weeks, I have been seeing him regularly. To be specific or precise, I've seen him 4 times in a vision. The first time, I'm going to relate only the first time, how I saw him the first time. The first time, not the first time as in earlier times, because it's not the first time I am talking about him. Today I'm talking about him because in his nation is just about to be unveiled. He has already been unveiled. It's just that some people are resisting reality, but he has been unveiled. Things will be formalized from now onwards. After this celebration of Rosh Hashanah, things will be catalyzed in that country. Whether they like it or not, things will begin to move. What? Very fast. They will move very fast. And we are helping intercessors there to understand that they are entering into a new season, the season of this next king. But over the past 2 weeks, I've been seeing him regularly, 4 times to be precise. The first time I saw him was when he was standing on one of the high mountains in northern Uganda. He was standing on one of the high mountains in northern Uganda. Hallelujah. And he was carrying a giant spear, a very big spear. It's not possible for one person to carry that spear. In terms of thickness, it was bigger than my arm. And my arm is quite big. It was very big. It was a very thick spear. But you know, in a vision or in a dream, in a vision, you can see things which are not possible in the natural. So he was carrying this very giant and a long spear. The spear was almost 3 meters long in terms of length, but he was holding it halfway, just holding it in the air. And then he made a piercing motion, first to the east, then to the north, then west, and lastly in the southern direction to symbolize conquests. He then threw the spear. And then when he threw the spear, he threw the spear like it's just nothing into the atmosphere, into the air. When he threw the spear, it was carried by a very big wind. There is a wind which just came, which was flowing. It carried that spear, and the spear fell without hurting anyone near a very big lake. There is a very big lake in Uganda there. The spear just came and fell very nicely near a very big lake without hurting anyone. And then I saw some fishermen. Some fishermen were on a boat in that lake fishing. One of the fishermen just swam and tried to pick the spear. The spear was too heavy to carry. He discovered the spear is a very big piece of metal, which can't be carried by one person. And then I saw a group of preachers and some judges who helped each other to carry the spear, giving each other turns. At any given time, there were more than six people who were carrying the spear. More than six people would be carrying the spear. And there would be a combination of some judges and some preachers. They were giving each other turns to carry the spear, until they reached the royal palace, which is not far away from the lake. When the delegation of preachers and judges reached the royal palace, that same man that I had seen in the vision earlier on, who had thrown the spear, was standing at attention in front of one of the buildings there at the royal palace, in the courtyard, where as you are approaching that building, with a contingent of soldiers who were wearing two sets of uniforms. Those who were standing directly in front of him, they were wearing uniforms which are olive green. And then those who were standing by the sides in other rows facing this central group, they were wearing dark military green uniforms. The moment he saw the preachers and judges come with his spear, singing some Christian worship songs, this same man who was standing at attention in front of the soldiers, he left the soldiers standing at attention and ran towards the preachers and the judges. And then he fell at the feet of two elderly preachers who I saw laying hands on him. Two elderly male preachers, they laid hands on him. He fell on his feet. And then when they finished laying hands on him, I saw a certain woman also among the preachers praying as well and playing a tambourine as they were walking now. Some preachers and churches, they were still carrying that spear as if they are now walking into the house, which was in front of the courtyard. This woman, when she finished praying, she was playing a tambourine and also singing very loud. She was singing in front of that delegation. The Spirit of God says the new king of Uganda is just about to be unveiled. He will be both tough and gentle at the same time. He will have a heart minded after the things of the kingdom of God. During his reign, the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ shall prosper and flourish. God will use him to bring about and instill peace, even in the East African region. He will continue the legacy of the current king, but he will have his own voice and his own ways and means. There are some who will try to cause trouble for him, especially at the early stages of his reign, but they will not succeed, because the preachers that pray and the believers that pray, I see them standing around his throne to strengthen it through supplications, prayers, and thanksgiving. He will not hide his faith in God. He will pray openly and proclaim God's goodness openly. Amen. So this is what I've seen. Let us stand and pray for Uganda. Father, we pray for the nation of Uganda. We say, let your counsel be established in that nation. Father, we know that there are some who will be disappointed at hearing this message because they do not know your will and your purpose for that nation. Father, I declare that your will and your purpose will flourish and it will prevail in that nation. That, Father, your wisdom is better than our wisdom. And what you have designed is better than what we designed. Father, let your ways be established in our generations. Let your ways be established in Uganda. And Father, let the drums of war, let the drums of violence fail in the name of Jesus Christ. I say, let your counsel prevail. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.